Now we have to refurbish the coffee grinder and we are ready to test the machine. The first thing that I see is, if you can spot it, this plastic ring here is maybe 1.5 millimeter up. It's not on the right place, and here is okay, you can see. And here is open. So what that means, you can see here, if you use the grinder in this condition, it will grind very bad, and it's not good for the coffee. So what we have to do is to replace this ring, because this is the problem. So first you have to be careful. You have a metal bowl here, and you have to be careful not to lose it, because it's a problem. So first we remove the coffee. You can see how it's not fine grinded. You can have a good coffee from this type of grind. So you can hear the metal ball here. So you have three plastic teeth here. Have to remove them. Okay, be careful. Here is the metal bowl. It's very important not to lose it, and there is a spring. You can see you have one moment you have this metal bowl and the spring. Don't lose it. So now, what happened here, you can see these three pieces here keep this ring attached on the right place. So when, I don't know if you can see, this edge here is where the teeth cannot keep the ring on the place and slide. And what it's happened is the blades are not aligned, are in some kind of warp position, and from the one side you have zero place for the coffee to go out, and from the other place it's too much. So we need to replace this ring. So let me see first. The blades are okay. I'm not going to replace them, but if you want, you can replace them. So what we need to do is to remove the conical blade. And it's the other, it's unscrew, reverse unscrew, if you can see here. That unscrew is that way for this. Okay, be careful. You can see here three metal balls again. Okay, and this one is below. So what I will replace actually is, let me show you. Okay. Now you have this one. You can see it's okay, but I will replace it with new one, so it's the same. You can see this is very white and this is brown. So what will happen eventually with this, I will show you. The coffee will make a hole inside this plastic and the grinded coffee will go inside the mechanism here and will destroy your coffee grinder, and you have to replace the whole thing. So I will replace it with the new one. Okay, and also I will check the brushes, the electric brushes here, because very often they are also for replacement. You can buy a new one. You have to buy something like almost the same and make it to fit. So first I will check the minus cable, because most of the time the minus is very bad. It's not okay. I can see it's enough. You can see if the minus is okay, the plus is also okay. So I need to check it, because if you assemble the machine and after 1 or 2 months you have a problem with this, you have to do it again. And now we have to assemble the coffee grinder. Of course, the new plastic. This is very important to put it back. I will use a brush to clean here, so the new ring will fit perfectly and it work very nice. Okay, you can take your time and clean it very good with water and something, but for now it's okay. Okay, so two of these are smaller and the third is bigger. So you can see here is the bigger. Okay, so now you put the spring and the metal ball and the new ring. Be careful, push. You can hear the mechanism. So this is the old one. I will throw it away. And here, okay, so it's clean. Now we have these three rubbers. You can see and it's difficult to, if you don't do it from the first time, do it second and third time and we'll go. The springs, three springs, the metal balls here. Okay, and I will use the same blade because it's good, it's replaced. So I will replace this. Let me show you the new one, and you can see how it's look when it's new and when it's old. So this make the coffee beans to the blades, and if you don't have it, it need more time to grind for the same amount of coffee to grind. So I will replace with new. Okay, it has to be the right way. You have to look and okay. It's enough. When it's turned with the screw, you don't need to tighten the screw more. So now we assemble the coffee grinder. I will clean only this here. Okay. So now you can see blue and red. You go here, you have blue and red here, you go blue and blue. The all three pieces here has to go simultaneously, and you go to the red. So I personally go few clicks more, and from here I, when the coffee grinder is on the machine, I will adjust how fine it has to be the coffee. Maybe a little bit more or a little bit less, but the rule for me is when you have on zero, you have to turn the ring 1/4. Okay? Somewhere here for me, maybe here or here. You can do it when you start the machine. You can adjust this. So let me show you. Here is the machine, and cable goes down. Okay, and push the lever on maximum so this plastic doesn't make a problem for you. You need to now. So I need the three screws here. Okay, as you can see. And after that, we connect the grinder to the electronic of the machines, and we can test the machine if it's everything okay. And if you remove the cables from the coffee grinder, and because it's using direct current, it matter the polarity. So if you can see here is how it has to be. So if the grinder doesn't turn this way and turn the other way, you don't need to disassemble the grinder and to change the cables on the grinder. You need just to reverse here and put it this way, and the grinder will start to turn the opposite direction because it's direct current and not alternated current. So you cannot test it on The grinder you cannot test on the electric grid directly, only on the machine. So this is how you can refurbish your grinder unit on your Saeco machine, and this is almost for every Saeco machine is almost the same, maybe not exactly, but it's almost the same. So I hope it's a good video for you, and see you next time. Bye.